Hello everyone, myself Venu, lecturer in mechanical engineering from Government Polytechnic Warangal, and dealing the subject is refrigeration and air conditioning. So today's video session, the topic or lecture goes on the air conditioning equipment. So here in the if you observe in the last previous video session, so we have seen the fundamentals of air conditioning, like what is the difference between the refrigeration and air conditioning, definition of the air conditioning, and we have seen the term human comfort and seen some factors controlling the human comfort. In the continuation, so you know, here in the air conditioning system, the important part is the refrigeration system. So for proper cleaning and the circulation of air at a desired comfortable temperatures at required place, the additional following equipment is also needed. Okay, it means for proper cleaning and circulation of an air at a desired comfortable temperatures, it means so additional equipments are necessary. Refrigeration, as a part, we have seen some main components like a compressor, condenser, and like expansion device, evaporator, only these only. But proper air conditioning, it determines where air is blowing inside the room. Okay, so circulation of air is taking place, and the cleaning or whatever the odor present in the room is get cleaned, and air purity is maintained. So for these additional equipments are required here, right? So now in this today class, these objectives, your upon completion you can able to understood the regarding the air conditioning equipment. So in that we will see the how the fan is very important component, how to select the fan, the selection of the fans with the classifications, the axial flow fans, and also the centrifugal fans also. Okay, so we'll see that come next. Here, as I already told that the following equipments are needed for circulating the air and for cleaning a fresh air inside the space. And the equipments here we can list out, those are the fans and blowers, ducts, air filters, dust collectors, and heating and cooling coils, and some other like the grills and resistors, humidifiers and dehumidifiers, any other equipment needed for the air distribution system. So all these are the requirements. So in today's class we will see the fans and blowers, the types, different types, classifications we will see, and we will see some line diagram regarding the fans, what are the importance of that, and what is a fan, what is a blower. So we will see all these things in today's video session. So coming to the fans, so here fan, by the term we are using, whenever it is handling the quantity of air handling at a small capacity, it means the small capacity air handling equipment can be considered as a fan. Okay, we are using the term for that particular thing when they are used for smaller capacity. Similarly, blower, the term when it comes means when it is handling the larger capacity of air, that handling equipment can be taken as a blowers. Fans, blowers, larger capacity air handling equipment. Now here a fan is used to discharge air against a pressure, either it may be fan or blower, they are against a pressure they are discharging the air. So here a fan which is used to discharge the air against a pressure at its outlet is termed as a blower. In the air conditioning equipment, mostly they are using these blowers in a different equipments of air conditioning. And whereas when you call it as a exhauster, so blower means against a pressure you are discharging the air. What the exhauster means, फैन रिमूव्स द एयर और गैस फ्रॉम ए स्पेस बाई सक्शन इज कॉल्ड एग्जास्टर. सो एग्जास्टर्स आर मोस्टली यूज इन द रूम्स टू रिमूव एनी एयर और गैसेज और एनी स्मोक और वॉट एवर प्रेजेंट इन द रूम. सो इट विल बी सक्ड बाई दैट पर्टिकुलर फैन एंड इट विल बी सेंड आउट साइड. सो दैट फैन कैन बी रिफर्ड एज ए एग्जास्टर. ओके द नेक्स्ट द सेलेक्शन ऑफ द फैन हियर for a particular air conditioning installation requires how much the volume of air required to be circulated. How much volume of air is required to be circulated? It means they are taking in terminology of meter cube per minute. Okay, so in meter cube per minute, and here that is the one thing, one requirement. Next, the total static pressure loss includes resistance offered by the air filters, washers, coils, elbows, bend walls and duct resistance. So here whatever the static pressure, the total static pressure inbuilt in that, some loss includes, some losses are there which includes the resistance offered by air filters. Those are air filters or the washers, coils, elbows, all of them is making, the air is making contact with that. Some losses has to be taken into consideration here. Okay, so this is regarding the requirement of the, during selection of a fan. And coming to the classification, so according to the maximum total pressure, they are divided into different class categories. It is a class 1. So developing the maximum pressure up to 95 mm of water gauge, that is a class 1. Class 2 is up to 171 mm of water gauge, and class 3 is up to 311 mm of water gauge, and class 4 is over 311 mm of water gauge. So this is regarding that first classification. Next, according to the air flow pattern, how they are, in which pattern they are flowing, it means just like in straight way or in a circular manner. So depending on that pattern, they are divided into, and the first one is axial flow fans. It means here how we can decide it is axial flow fan means when the air flow parallel to the axis, there is a shaft where the fan is provided, so parallelly the air is also going to flow, so that can be taken as the axial flow fans. Whereas the centrifugal fans, so air enters axially and delivers radially. So it is entering axially means parallel to the axis, and delivers radially. Whenever it is moving exit, exit will be in a different way. They are not moving in a parallel to the axis. They are radially, it is moving outside. Those are referred as centrifugal fans. Okay. So we'll move on to the first the classification. So depending on the how the flow pattern is taking place, that is the axial flow fans. They are again subdivided into three types. Axial flow fans, those are the propeller fans, tube axial fans, vane axial fans. So these three are referred again as axial flow fans, where the air flow is taken parallel to the axis of that fan. So we'll deal one by one regarding these propeller, tube axial fans and vane axial fans. So this is the diagram. So just you can note regarding that, the propeller fans. So you can note, just have what are the components involved in the propeller fans. We'll discuss regarding that, what is the propeller fans. The first thing is it is a axial fan. It is a one type of a axial fan. This is a propeller fan is, you can observe there. So whatever the disc with the wheel they are using, the fan wheel they are using, they are named as disc type of or propeller type of a wheel they are using, on which it is mounted on a mounting ring or a plate is there. So this fan arrangement where it is connected to a shaft or electric motor, shaft to the electric motor. So this total arrangement is placed on the mounting ring or plate. So you can see at the left side of that there are some dampers. So whatever the air is sucked by that, so it can be blown over the through these dampers or through these grills, and the air will come outside through the propeller fans. Okay, so air flow is in this direction. You can observe in the diagram here. So you can see this is the direction of airflow, and air is coming outside through this. Okay, so here in this propeller fans, the quantity of air delivered is very smaller quantity of, whenever the requirement is to send the quantity of air supply delivered is very small, and the cost is also one criteria. When cost requirement is very low, so these type of fans can be utilized here. So here, coming to the species regarding these propeller fans continuation. So as already discussed, these propeller fans are used for low pressures. So when the air movement is small and capacity required is very small, used for low pressure, so these propeller fans can be employed there. And if you observe how to identify that, generally if you observe the blade, the fan blades are there, right, maybe the disc type of a wheel, generally known as a propeller, or a disc type of a structure you can see, so which are and operates on the mounting ring. So there is a mounting ring where it has supported on that mounting ring, so on that it can be rotated there. Now generally if coming to the application, so they are used in ventilations of the lattice space laboratories and the bathrooms, and removal of cooling, so orders from kitchen, etc. So these small propeller fans are provided here. So this is regarding the first axial fan, where the requirement is for a small axial smaller capacity with low cost, and where it requires the low pressure, air movement is small, these propeller fans can be employed there. Next, coming to the second category or second type of the axial fans, those are the tube axial fans. So if you look at the diagram, you can easily identify, generally they are accommodated in a hollow type of a member in that structure. You can see in a circular type. So this is the diagram for a tube axial fan, where you can see again the same design of a fan wheels. You can see the disc type of wheels or a propeller wheels. If with the same arrangement, instead of placing on the propeller stand, whatever the mounting is there, instead of that mounting, so see, you can see it is placed in a cylindrical housing. Completely, it was placed in a cylindrical type of structure. You can see at the around that propeller or disc type of wheel, so which is attached with this motor. So you can observe here there is an air flow here in this direction. The air is flowing and it enters into the tube. Then it, with the help of this disc type of wheel, which whenever it is rotated, air with a little pressure, when compared with the propeller type, it will used for little more pressure requirement than the propeller fans. So these type of fans can be employed there. So coming to here, right, so these are heavy duty propeller fans. This is also one type of a propeller fan only, but compared to the propeller, the basic one, it does the heavy duty. But a main disadvantage in it is more noisy than compared to the propeller fan. Okay, so here this the propeller wheel of these fans are housed in a tube and can be easily installed in the round ducts. So here we are using the term, that is a duct, just like a hollow member, in which whenever the air is passing through it from one section to other section, generally they are named as a duct. So it will act like a passage to move the air from one section to the other section. Those are known as the ducts. So in the round duct, when we are placing these arrangement, the electric motor along with the fan blade or disc type of wheel, so they can be taken as a tube axial fan. And here, as I already told, whenever they are rotating, giving out its the movement, the fan movement creates very high noise, but compared with the propeller fans, they are more efficient. Okay, it means more pressure, more pressured air can be come out through this tube axial fan compared with the normal propeller fan, and used in handle wide range of air volume against the medium discharge. Okay, so large range of the air volume can be made, can be handled when it requires some medium discharge. So these tube axial fans can be employed here. Okay, next the vane axial fans. Here, this is the diagram for vane axial fans. So this is the third type of axial fans, that is a vane axial fan. So vanes on here, it will also look like a blades, nothing but a blade, where these vanes are used for guiding purpose. Okay, what happens if you provide these guide vanes? You can observe in this diagram, they are also very similar to the arrangement of just like in the previous case in the tube axial fan. Here also it is placed in the tube, here you are using the fan blades here. So additional to that, the guide vanes are provided. It will also look like some blade type of structure. They may be fixed one. So these guide vanes just guide the air which is entering through the inlet section, and it will guide and move in an axial way. So in some previous cases, what happens, due to the irregular movement of the air, it creates some lot of noise there. Whenever these guide vanes will allow to move in a particular direction, in the same direction, the whirling movement of the air can be reduced, and the noise can be reduced very, very much lower compared to the previous cases. So this is what advantage in this vane axial fan. So just let us see a few sentences regarding these fans. So here, when the same tube axial fan, as we have seen in the last case, then it will, when it is taken along with the vanes or the guide vanes, so it consists of an axial flow wheel with a cylindrical housing. The same arrangement, all the arrangements is the same, except that extra the blades are provided, which are used for guiding the air to reduce the noise, or to reduce the whirling motion, the rotational motion of the air here. You can see that the vanes are located at the leaving side of the wheel. Okay, so after the inlet, whenever the air is sucked here, the pressurized air, whenever it is passing through outlet, so at that place these vanes are fixed to the motor side, where it will guide there. Okay, so at air enters a spiral and comes out an axial flow. So this is how we can reduce the more noise in this vane axial fan as compared to the tube axial fan. So what happened here, air is entering spirally, so somewhat in a irregular format it will enter, and if you see the help of these guide vanes, comes out in an axial flow. So as the air leaves in a straight line flow, the operation is noiseless. Okay, and it eliminates the spiral flow discharge, so reduces the turbulence flow because of the guide vanes. So installed easily in the duct system. So this is you can observe the diagram again, the same duct around cylindrical duct system is placed, a motor along with the shaft and the fan blades are provided. You see here also you can use some propeller type or disc type of wheel of a structure can be used, but extra arrangement here is to the motor at the exit side, some guide vanes are provided, where it reduces the spiral flow of the air at the discharge, and only the axial flow will take place in a smooth manner, where the noise can be reduced. So coming to the sizes here, the size from 18 inch to 72 inch capacity to 20,000 cubic feet. So if you see the sizes, up to 18 inch to 72 inch, and the capacity is coming to the capacity where air volume may be taken as 20,000 cubic feet, and static pressure up to 72 inch water gauge. Static pressure up to to 72 inch hot gauge. So these are the capacities of that. So these are the three types of the axial fans: propeller type, tube axial fans, and vane axial fans. So a little minor differences are there, where when we are going for low pressures and low velocity, low speeds, and we can employ the propeller type of a design. It's a very mostly used fan, and if it has to be housed in a cylindrical type of structure, we can employ for the tube axial fan. If you want to reduce the the noise creation, the additional blades can be provided, or vanes, where it is known as a vane axial fan. So a lot of three different type of axial flow type of fans can be seen here. So where you can see the movement of the air is going exactly parallel to the axis of the shaft where your electric motor shaft is there. So to that, the air flow is making parallel to the axis there. So those type of fans can be taken as axial fans. Okay. Next type here you can see, the next one is the centrifugal fans. So coming to the centrifugal fan, so these are also called as a radial fans. Why they are called as a radial fans? So centrifugal in the sense, you have to remember that the centrifugal force will come into existence. So how we will how the air is entering into the system and how the air is leaving the centrifugal fan. So by looking at that condition, we will tell it is a centrifugal fan. So more high pressures compared to the axial fans, more high pressure discharge can be seen in these centrifugal fans. So how the air enters means it enters axially and discharges at periphery. Axially discharges at periphery. So used in the duct air conditioning system, so more pressure developed than axial fan. So entering is axially, so to the shaft it enters axially, but if you see the leaving section, it means at the exit, it will leave the radially. Okay, leaves radially. So mostly it is used in the air conditioning system, so duct type of air conditioning system. As already explained, ducts, where the air passage is created, it may be a rectangular type or a circular type of a duct system. So more pressures is developed than the axial fans. Why? Because due to change in its direction, and more pressure can be created in this type of a centrifugal fans. So now you can observe the diagram here regarding the centrifugal fans. So here is the inlet. You can see there is an impeller section, this round inner round section which is there, where the blades are provided to that. Maybe a straight blades or forward curved blades or backward curved blades. So depending on the direction how the impeller is rotating, and see the inlet is exactly at the center of the impeller or eye of the impeller. It is exactly at the center that air is entering axially. Now due to the centrifugal action created by the impeller, whatever due to its rotation, so you can see a housing is provided here, a casing will be there. So the high pressurized air will be sent outside at this is a section, outlet section is the air outlet is there. So air will come outside with high pressure. To run this impeller, to run this shaft, here you can see electric motor is placed along with the belt system. This is a very old one, old designed centrifugal fan here. But the principle behind inside that, where it is creating the centrifugal force on the particles of air, that is a centrifugal force here. Those are known as a centrifugal fans. So let us see a few further discussion regarding these centrifugal fans. So it consists of an impeller running in casing of a volute shape. Okay, so it consists of an impeller. So at the center you can see, so here we have the, so here this is this, whatever the placed here. So exactly at the center the air is coming axially. Okay, axially here the air is entering and leaves by its rotational motion. What happens, it will leaves out like this, it will leaves outside, it will enter at the center. So due to rotation of the impeller, it will rotates and creates high pressure, and it will come outside through this section. So it consists of an impeller running in the casing of a volute shape. So a different different shape is given designed for this volute casing or housing. So due to that, more pressure of pressurized air can be sent outside at exit. So here this is a exact diagram. You can see the first diagram, you can see here this is the housing along with the impeller at the centers. So whatever the eye of the impeller at the center, you can see through that the air is coming inside that. Here these are the impellers. They may be a forward curved. If you see exactly that blade, impeller blade, they may be forward curved or backward curved or straight blades. You can see how the outlet section is open. It may be a very bigger rectangular type of a section, you can see here, where the air is coming out through these fans. These are the impellers of the centrifugal fans with the different shapes you can observe here. They may be backward, they may be forward curved, they may be straight blades. Okay, just see the line diagram also of that different impellers of centrifugal fans. So classifications of the centrifugal fans here, you can see forward curved blade fans, radial blade fans, and backward curved blade fans. So you will see all these three, how they are placed according to the direction of rotation of the impeller. How these three types can be seen, so just we'll see the first one, that is the forward curved blade fan. Okay. Now this is a diagram for forward curved blade fan. So just have a look regarding the diagram, and you can see the points there. First of all, you can read out them, you can see for some time, and you can get some idea regarding that how they are named as the forward curved blade fan. So depending on the rotation, okay, this is regarding the one type of centrifugal impeller, that is a forward curved blade fan. So if you observe the diagram here, the figure is showing the direction of rotation here, and how they are named as a forward curved means depending on the direction. For example, if you are taking here in this diagram, the impeller rotation is a clockwise direction, and blades bend towards the direction of the rotation. You can see in the same direction the blades, what are the impeller blades are there in between the two diameters of that sections, it is bent forward, so they are taken as a forward curved blade. So depending on the rotation, so here if you observe these the motions here, the first motion, one can be a motion imparted to air by shape of the blade. So the first whatever the motion developed here, so that motion imparted to air by the shape of the blade, and the second motion you point to, it can be taken as in the horizontal direction. You can see here motion imparted to air by fan wheel rotation. So one motion is due to the shape of the blade, and second motion is due to the rotation, the fan wheel rotation. So the resultant of these two motions can be given as the resultant motion of air leaving fans due to 1 and 2. Resultant motion of air leaving fan due to 1 and 2. Due to both the motions, the resultant motion is taken as like this. And here the tip of the blade is curved forward with respect to the direction of rotation of the fan wheel. As I explained where the rotation, if you observe, it is a clockwise direction, and if you observe the tip of the blade, which is bent to along with the direction of the rotation of the impeller, tip is curved forward, so they named as a impeller of a forward curved blade fan. So further we will see regarding this forward curved blade fan. Now if you observe here, so blade tip is curved forward. This is the main point. How do you identify the forward curved blade fan? So depending on taking the reference as the rotation of that impeller, and used in a window type AC, window type air conditioner with a drum type construction. So where you can see the inside of that drum window air conditioner, a drum type of structure there, in which the impeller you can see there. Okay, in those types you can see the forward curved blade fans produce the highest pressure for a given diameter and the speed. So it will give the highest pressures, as we have seen that compared to the axial fans, these this centrifugal fans with a forward curved blade produces the highest pressure for a given diameter and speed. Next, so these are smaller. So coming to some specifications and importance of that, they are very smaller and lighter in weight and slower running fans. So it's work with an efficiency up to 75%. So if you can take the reference of that, so if you observe the efficiency of that the forward curved blade works with an efficiency of about 75%, and they are very smaller, lighter and slower running fans. So the next, coming to the second type, that is a radial blade fans. So meanwhile, you can observe the diagram. So compared to that forward curved blade, how they are placed here. So this is regarding the diagram of impeller of a radial blade fan. So you can observe the diagram. They are very straight, taken from the inner ring to the outer ring, the connection. There is a straight line you can see here. So they're taking the first one, that is the motion imparted to the air by the shape of the blade, whereas the same similar to the forward curved blade. So if you take the first motion, that is a imparted to the air by the shape of the blade, so very similar to the as a forward curved blade. And next, second motion you can take here, the horizontal component, that is motion imparted to air by the fan wheel rotation. So same as again the forward curved blade. The first motion is due to the shape of the blade, and second motion is due to the fan wheel rotation. And resultant of both of them can be taken as where the air leaving the fan, that is due to 1 and 2, the motion 1 and 2. So this is the impeller of a radial blade fan. The radial blade fan, you can see straight blade can be seen from the inner ring to up to the outer ring. Okay, so similarly, you can observe here, there is no curvature, blade has no curvature, fixed radially here. Okay, so to that radially of that inner ring, so they are fixed. And if you observe the blade shape, it has no curvature, it has a straight shape. And so you can see the same thing again, the blades are straight from hub and fixed radially. So hub is nothing but from the center, so where on which the shaft is fixed here, impeller is fixed on the shaft, so that is the hub portion. And blades are used in electric motors for internal cooling. So this is application where this radial blade fan arrangement is used. So used in electric motors for internal cooling, and so develop the highest pressure at the high speed. So in smaller size blades are built in rotor itself. So here it develops the high pressure, very similar to as a forward curved blade. Develops the high pressure at the very higher speeds. Whenever it making higher rotation speed, so the pressure developed is also very high. So in smaller size, if you take these impellers, these are radial blade fans, blades are built in rotor itself. Okay, whatever the rotor is there, so itself the blades are built. In some cases they may arrange it independently here. So separate fan is fixed on motor shaft in big motors. Separate fan is fixed on motor. Okay, so similarly it can also have the work efficiency of about 75%, very similar to as a forward curved blade. And coming to the next one, that is a backward curved blade fan. So observe the diagram. A slight change in that, if you observe the forward and the backward curved blade, what I have taken the reference there, depending on the rotation. Here the rotation is a clockwise direction of the impeller, and you can observe the blade is bent towards back, exactly opposite to the direction of the rotation. Okay, so this is the impeller of the backward curved blade fan. Observing the motions here, again the same, you can take the vertical component as first motion imparted to the air by the shape of the blade. Again same similar manner here. If you take the second point as a horizontal motion imparted to the air by fan wheel rotation,
imparted there by fan wheel rotation. One is due to the shape of the blade, one and the second one is due to the fan wheel rotation. And resultant of both of them, where the air leaving the fans due to 1 and 2 is in this direction. Okay, so now you can see the tip of the blade here at the bottom. You can see the dial. The tip of the blade is curved backward with respect to fan wheel rotation. With respect to the fan wheel rotation, they are bent backward. Okay, you see here when it is just like when you make contact with that, they bend towards back. Okay, just like that you can see that. So, or it may be bent towards opposite of that to the direction. It is in the clockwise direction, the bend is also taken place in that same similar direction, in the opposite direction they have bent. Okay, now observe some point here. The tip of the blade is curved backward or away from the direction of the rotation of the fan wheel. So this is how you can identify that those are the backward curved blade fan used in bigger installations. Okay, so this backward curved blade, so when the requirement is regarding the bigger installations, so these type of backward curved blade fans can be used. Okay, and need higher speeds and more sturdy constructions. So more efficiency compared to the forward and radial curved radial blade fans. It works with an efficiency of about 80%, and very higher speeds can be get here in this things. So coming to the summary part here, so you can observe we have mostly concentrated on the air conditioning equipments. That is regarding the mainly in fans we have seen, in their classifications we have seen that axial fan and centrifugal fans. In the axial fan we have seen the three different types. In that one is a propeller fan, tube axial fan and vane axial fan, and the centrifugal fan also we have seen, where the three different types of impellers we have seen, like forward curved blade, radial blades and backward curved blade we have seen in the centrifugal fan impellers. Okay, so coming to the quiz part here, just we look at these small questions regarding that, so you can answer them. Large quantity of air handling equipment is known as wheel, propeller, fan, blower. So the answer is the blower. So more to create high pressures and to handle the large quantity of air, generally we are going for the blowers. Okay, next, similarly, tube axial fan of air is, so options are heavy duty propeller fan, light duty propeller fan, heavy duty axial fan and light duty axial fan. So they are tube axial fans, very similar to the propeller fan. You can observe the shape of that blade. They are a disc type. Okay, and propeller, generally we are naming it as a disc type or propeller fans. They are heavy duty. Next one is centrifugal fans are also known as. Okay, so generally they can also known as, options you can see here, it is a propeller fan, a tube axial fan, radial flow fan and vane axial fan. So those are the radial flow fans. So these propeller, tube axial, vane axial, all these three are axial flow fans, and only the centrifugal fan is radial flow fan. Okay, we are using the impeller structure, radial flow the fan impeller is used. Large quantity of another question, large quantity of air handling equipment is known as wheel, propeller, fan, blower. Again the same thing, blower is the answer. Tube axial fan of air, again the same thing, heavy duty propeller fan, maybe repeated again. Centrifugal fans are also known as radial flow fan. So forward curved blade work efficiencies, answer is we have seen up to 75% they are working. Okay, backward curved blades are more efficient compared to radial and forward curved blades. They are 80%. So backward curved blade work efficiency up to 80% is the answer. Backward curved blade work efficiency. So these are the some frequently asked questions. You can see that. So illustrate the working of a propeller fan. They may ask along with the diagram, you have to explain the propeller fan, the function, and you have to draw the diagram. Illustrate the working of a tube axial fan and vane axial fan. How centrifugal fans are classified, explain any two of them. So depending on the impeller what you are choosing there, so they here and you can list out them and you can explain any two of them. Okay, next. So this is regarding the air conditioning equipment. Only we have seen only one part, that is regarding the fans, blowers, whatever the name it may be called. So depending on the air handling volume, so they may be called as a fan for lesser speeds, for higher speeds and more air handling, you can call it as blowers. Okay, next, continuation in the next classes we have seen regarding, you will see regarding other equipments like another equipments in the air conditionings, like we will see that duct systems, so different equipments will be there in the air conditionings. We'll explain additional equipments there. Okay, so thank you for watching, and we will meet in the next video session, and hope you can also watch some videos regarding this air conditioning equipment. You can watch later after completion of these.